Hey everybody, happy Monday. I hope you had a great weekend. If you're in Phoenix, I hope you enjoyed the change in weather. We got a little bit of rain on Friday and some cooler temps this weekend, which was nice. Probably our last cool experience until we get to the fall, I would imagine. I think from now on it's going to start to heat up, and sooner than later we'll be in the hot summer months. But not yet. We still have March and April, which are my two favorite months here, so I plan to enjoy the weather. But anyway, let's talk real estate updates. So a big update for you guys this week. For the first time ever, I am reporting that the CMI actually went down. It went down to 512.6, which is pretty much not significant, but it is down. So you're not going to notice a change at all in our market with this number, but it is the first time that it's actually gone down. And over the last 6 to 7 days, it's been kind of leveling off rather than increasing. So that definitely gives us an indication that things are changing. Now, this is nothing that you're going to notice if you're a seller or a buyer right now. This does not mean that prices are going down. This does not mean that there's a crash. This does not mean that, you know, there's going to be a ton of homes for sale. None of this is an indication of a big change in that way. We're going to have to see where this trend takes us. You just won't feel a difference in this market. So maybe as a seller, you'll get 20 offers instead of 25 offers. And as a buyer, maybe you're only competing against 20 people instead of 25. That's about it. It's really not changing how this market feels at all. But over the long term, if we continue to see this trend of the CMI stabilizing or even going down, that might change our market a little bit. Right now, the demand has gone down significantly. It was about 35% above normal back in December. It's continued to go down, and now we're sitting at about 15% above normal. And it's going down about 8 points a week. So if that trend continues, I mentioned this last week, you know, that will go down significantly. And if we get into balance or below normal on the demand side, we might actually see supply increase to meet that lower demand. So in which case, that would be great to see some additional listings. We're also hoping that if there are some folks ready to list their homes, once forbearance comes due, we'll see a little bit of spike in inventory as far as that goes, but nothing really significant, nothing really promised there. It's just a bit of speculation of what could possibly happen, knowing that forbearance is coming due at the end of this month, if it's not extended again. So that's the big change. CMI went down largely because demand has gone down and has been going down significantly. Our supply is still super low. It's sitting at 22, so that's 78% below normal. That has not really changed all that much. It's just staying low. We just keep losing our demand, and so that's what's affecting our CMI. We'll see how this happens in the long term because, or what happens in the long term, because this is an indication that we kind of took our foot off the gas. We're not increasing in the trajectory of the CMI. And if we start to stabilize or even start turning downward, things can definitely change in the near future. But again, this is not signifying any sort of price crash or the bottom falling out or anything horrible like that. It's just that we're having a little bit of a shift in the market. And why is that? Why is demand falling? One of the reasons could be interest rates. Interest rates did tick up a little bit lately. Also, Fannie Mae is talking about changing or tightening up some of the lending practices on investment loans. So if that is something that will occur, we may have fewer investors out there purchasing property. So that could change our demand a little bit as well. A few different factors on that. So we'll see what happens. Just looking at my notes here because I had a few different things that I wanted to talk about. for interest rates, those increasing interest rates, just wanted to give you some context as to why that affects buyers, because it changes your monthly payment. So what you can afford goes down a little bit. So for instance, the way interest rates have changed over the last 1 to 2 weeks, your monthly payment pretty much went up by $133 a month if you're buying at a higher interest rate versus where we were before. It's still a super low payment as it relates to history, but you know, $133 a month is kind of significant when it comes to your overall budget. Our median rental prices are still around $1,850, so that hasn't changed. And if you're really looking at the difference between buying and renting, buying is a more affordable option, of course, if you have that down payment. We are still accepting more contracts on a weekly basis than what's being listed for sale. So as far as supply goes, it's not going up at all, because for as many that are being listed, we're still getting more of those under contract than new listings. So we're kind of just in this deficit again with supply. Nothing has changed there. Our median days on market is 5. I think it was 6 last week, or at least 2 weeks ago. So again, very low. 49% of listings are closing over the asking price, and the median amount over asking price is $10,100. Last week it was $10,000, this week it's $10,100, so that went up again. So if you are buying in Phoenix, know that you will likely have to go $10,000 over the asking price in order to get in the game, so to speak. Of course, this depends on your price range, location, a few different factors, and I can pull specifics for you. But as far as the median is concerned, we're seeing about $10,000 over the asking price for the median amount going over list price. Yay, if you're a seller, 10 grand more than what you listed for, that could be a very good thing. So we'll see what happens. Pretty big update with the CMI going down. We'll see if it continues to go down or just stays stable. Either way, that's a pretty big change from what we've been seeing, but we still anticipate prices will continue to increase for the rest of this year. Just because our demand goes down slightly or the CMI goes down slightly, it doesn't mean that prices are going to drop. We still have such a deficit of listings for sale. It's still so much scarcity that prices continue to increase and stay high. So that's your quick update for this week. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me anytime, call, text, or email. If there's anything specific you would like as it relates to your situation, your area, whatever data you want me to pull for you, I can probably find it. So just let me know and I'd be happy to help. I hope everyone has a great week, and I'll be back next week with another update, and Friday for another neighborhood tour. So make sure you come back for that. Hope everyone has a great day.